So here we are at AWFS at the American Woodworker booth. I'm with Paul Sellers, and I got to tell you, there is some amazing machinery, some incredible equipment, some high precision tools here, but there is not one piece of equipment in this show that compares to this man right here. You do magic with wood.
Well,
absolute magic.
I've been doing it 47 years, and skill is a building thing. You build skill.
Mm-hmm.
And what you're doing is you're really training your upper body. You're training your hands, you're training your hand-eye coordination.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't take 47 years. It's just a matter of a few hours every day.
Mm-hmm.
And if you keep working at it, you'll get the same skills I've got. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Absolutely. It's
mm-hmm.
not that you don't have to be doing it for 20, 30 years. You do it in a matter of weeks, start training your body in this three-dimensional woodworking,
mm-hmm.
and it suddenly comes. You suddenly click, and you're suddenly planing and using handsaws. You've got it.
Well, I tell you, you are completely one with the tool, though. I mean, you've got that harmony, that feel. I mean, it was really the first time I had ever thought about it or heard when you referenced, I'm listening to the wood.
Yeah.
Because the wood is talking to you,
yeah.
and you're listening to it, and you understand. It's like you and the piece of wood have a language that you communicate together with.
Yeah, I think that's the difference between machines and handwork. Most often with machines, you're always concerned about safety.
Mm-hmm.
That's the number one factor. And then you're listening to the machine to
right.
make sure nothing's running awry.
Right.
But with hand tools, you're listening. Not in this world we live in, we don't use terms like listen to the thickness of your shaving.
Right.
You know, you want to see it. So what we do is we listen for the sound that comes from the shaving. That tells us whether the plane is not set properly, whether
mm-hmm.
we're taking too much off one side and things like that. The same with the saw. When you're sawing the wood, you're listening for the saw. You're listening for where one saw cut meets another,
mm-hmm.
and you can hear the pitch changing. We're playing with sound here, and we're playing with light in a sense. We're looking for light, we're looking for sound, and actually affects all the senses. People don't
mm-hmm.
realize that.
Mm-hmm.
You've got
mm-hmm.
vibration in your arm, so you're listening and feeling. You're trying to counter vibration with your left hand and push with your right, and they two counter one another, and you get very smooth cuts that way.
And it was amazing watching you. I mean, you literally take it to that sensual level. I mean, it's like two lovers. It's you and that piece of wood, and you're in that rhythm moving, and you know what feels good, you know what looks good, and you know what gets the end result. It was incredible to watch what you were doing a few minutes ago.
I think that's what real woodworkers get into woodworking, and they're kind of steered towards the machine.
Mm-hmm.
And there's not many people like myself that can really give them a good example of how efficient hand tools really are. They don't know how to get a crisp, keen edge on their chisels. So if they're introduced to a rough saw that's been hanging on the barn wall for 30 years, it's not going to do the job. And they think, oh, it's me, oh, it's the tool, and they walk away from it. But when somebody gives you the exact tool that you need for the job and the sharp
mm-hmm.
tool, that's
mm-hmm.
what gives it the mm-hmm. power. So I refer to hand tools as power tools, that you're supplying the energy, you're giving it direction, your brain, hand-eye coordination is synchronized,
mm-hmm.
and you develop it as you grow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
And talk about developing. You've not only developed tremendous techniques, great form, unbelievable talents in creating objects out of wood, but you've done it for a lot of tremendous things. You've been the White House.
Yeah. We made furniture, two pieces for the White House. We were asked to design pieces. I did the designs, and then we were asked to make them, and we made them and delivered them to the White House.
Mm-hmm.
I've made furniture for different, I suppose, famous people
mm-hmm.
through the years. Yeah,
uh-huh.
I've been involved in that. It's been
mm-hmm.
it's been fun. I've enjoyed working with wood all my life, really.
And to even further that enjoyment, you've now given people the ability to enjoy it even more on their own and to learn. You have a DVD series.
I do, yeah. Yeah, the DVD series came as a result 23 years ago when I first came to America. I was invited by the Texas Arts and Crafts Foundation to teach some workshops, and I did that. And then from there it developed. I wanted to do a curriculum, so I started writing a curriculum, and that grew. And then I wanted to actually put it onto DVDs. So when I went back to England with three friends, we actually formed a film company
uh-huh.
Called Artisan Media, and we started to produce a series of DVDs. And they're high definition, they're top quality, and they really challenge the audience. They
mm-hmm.
really draw you into whether you could really work with wood this way. So we not only did that, but we paralleled it with a 320-page book. So the book references everything that's in the DVDs, and the DVDs reference everything in the book. So my traditional handwork is now conveyed through these DVDs, and we're anticipating that these will go into the schools in America and Canada and Mexico, wherever. Uh-huh. We're anticipating that they'll go throughout Europe, and that we'll be able to re-establishing an apprenticing strategy that will train a new generation of woodworkers, and it'll be young people, because one of the things about machines is it takes young people out of the sphere because they can't responsibly, you can't responsibly put 13-year-olds on bandsaws and planers and
so on.
So what this does is filling the niche that, that's been lost for probably 4 or 5 decades now.
Right.
So it's bringing it back. This is really an empowering of young people to find out and rediscover what woodworking is all about.
Right, and a form of expression that will give them a lifelong capability of creativity.
Yeah, once you establish the skills, it's exactly like riding a bike. It's like learning to swim. Once you've got it for life. And there is nothing anybody can take it away from you. You can split wood, you can make wooden spoons, spatulas. That's what the course does. You start with the very basics. But with the course, we're talking about the wood. We talk about the trees. We talk about the substance of the trees, the cell structure of the trees. We talk about how you cross-cut it and how you rip-cut it. And you work through all these different projects, up to making rocking chairs and dining tables and everything. So this is the first 7 DVDs of 30 that we're making. So we're really happy with what we've been producing.
And I can tell you the audience will be happy. The users, the people, the enthusiasts that want to learn will be very happy. Paul, phenomenal to
Thanks
meet
for
you.
Your
Thank
encouragement.
You so much. And I can't wait to watch some more of your work here.
Great. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.